there. On Main Street, there are a row of stores, horse blocks, and hitching posts in front of them. First automobile is going to come along in about 5 years. Along to Banker Cartwright, our town's richest citizen. This is up in the big White House up there on the hill. Here's the grocery store and Mr. Morgan's drugstore. Most everybody manages to look in these stores at least once a day. And this is our doctor's house, Doc Gibbs. Here are a couple of trellises for those they feel they need to have scenery. This is Miss Gibbs' garden. Corn, peas, beans, hollyhocks, and heliotrope. And a lot of burdock. Now in those days, the newspaper came out twice a week, Grover's from Orange Center. And this is Editor Webb's house, Miss Webb's garden. Same as Miss Gibbs's, but he's got a lot of sunflowers too. And this, a big buttermilk tree. Nice town, you know what I mean? Don't be very remarkable from out of this, so far we know. These days, the tombstones up there in the cemetery say 1660. They're Grovers and Cartwrights and Gibbs and Hershey's. Same names as around here now. Only a few lights on in town. The Joe Crow house, where Joe Jr.'s getting ready to deliver the morning paper. Across the tracks in the cottage, where Polish mothers just had twins. And in the depot, where Shorty Hawkins is getting ready to fly the 545 from Boston. There she is. Miss Doc Gibbs coming down Main Street now. And there's his wife coming down to make breakfast. Doc Gibbs died in 1930. New hospital's named after him. Miss Gibbs died first, a long time ago in fact. Went out to visit her daughter Rebecca with a married insurance man in Canton, Ohio, and died there. Pneumonia. But her body was brought back here. She's up in the cemetery now, in with a whole mess of Gibbses and Herseys. She was Julia Hersey before she married Doc Gibbs in the Congregational Church over there. In our town, we like to know the facts about everybody. There's Miss Webb coming down to get her breakfast, too. That's Doc Gibbs. Got the call to go to Polish town at 1:30 this morning. And there's Joe Crowell delivering the morning paper.
Morning, Doc.
Morning, Joe.
Watch your paper now?
Yes, I'll take it.
Anybody been sick, Doc?
No, Perry Twin's over in Polish Town. Joe, I see your teacher, Miss Foster, is going to get married.
Yes, sir. Over to a fella in Concord.
Why do you glare? How do you boys feel about that?
Well, of course it ain't none of my business, but I think if a person starts
3 a year.
Yes, now. Well, good night, Bill.
Good night, Mr. Webb.
Who's up there? Is that you, Myrtle?
No, it's me, Papa.
Emily, why aren't you in bed?
Like it was.
been rising all night.
Cy Krauser is all broken up about George Gibbs retiring from baseball.
Yes, sir, that's the way it goes. Why, Cy, back in 64, we had a ball player even George Gibbs couldn't have touched him. Name of Hank Todd. Went down to Maine to become a parson. Mighty fine ball player. How do you reckon the weather is, Howie?
Oh, been raining so heavy that maybe it'll clear up. Bill?
Howie?
Thank you. morning, Mr. Webb.
Good morning, George.
You don't believe in that superstition, do you, Mr. Webb?
There's a lot of common sense in superstitions, George.
Millions have fallen to George. You don't want to be the first to fly in the face of custom.
How is Emily?
Well, she hasn't waked up yet. I haven't heard a sound out of her.
Emily's asleep?
No wonder we're up till all hours sewing and packing. Now, I'll tell you what I'll do, George. You sit down here and drink this cup of coffee with Mr. Webb. And I'll run upstairs and see she don't surprise her. There's some bacon, too. Don't be long about it.
What were you going to say, Mr. Webb?
I don't know.
Give her up some long highlights.
Goodbye, Lizzie.
Oh, goodbye. I'm awful glad you were elected too, Emily.
Thank you.
Emily, why are you mad at me?
I'm not mad at you.
You've been treating me so funny lately.
Well, I guess if you ask me, I might as well say it right now. Oh, goodbye, Mrs. Corcoran.
Well, goodbye, Miss Corcoran. What is it? The men are naturally
you say it's even a waste of time. Why, you can get all that stuff in the mail that the government sends out. Well, my Uncle Luke, he's getting pretty old. He'd be ready for me to take over the farm tomorrow, if I could.
My.
Yeah, and like you say, being gone all that long time, all those new places with all those new people, why, if anything like that could happen, then I don't want to go. I guess new people probably aren't any better than old ones. I'll bet they almost never are. Emily, I feel you're as good a friend as I've got. I don't even go off and meet the people in other towns.
Well, maybe it's very important for you to go learn about cattle judging and soil and those things. Of course, I don't know.
Emily, I'm going to make up my mind right now. I won't go. I'll tell Pa about it tonight.
Why, George, it's a whole year away. I don't see why you'd decide right now.
Listen, Emily, I'm glad you spoke to me about that fault in my character. What you said was right, but if there's one thing wrong in it, it's when you said that I wasn't noticing people, and you, for instance. Why, you say you were watching me when I did everything. Why, I was doing the same thing about you all the time. Sure, I always thought he was one of the chief people I thought about. I always made sure where you were sitting in the bleachers and who you were with. For the past 3 days now, I've been trying to walk home with you, but something's always gotten in the way. Like yesterday, I was waiting on the wall to walk you home, and you walked home with Miss Corcoran.
Oh, George, life's awful funny. How could I have known that? Why, I thought...
Emily, I'm going to tell you why I'm not going to agriculture school. I feel that when you've found a person who you're very fond of, well, who's fond of you too, and cares about you well enough to pay attention to your character, why, I think that's just as important as college is, or even more so. That's what I think.
I think that's awful important, too.
Emily?
Yes, George?
If I do improve and make a big change, would you be? I mean, could you be?
Oh, George, I am now, and I always have been.
Then, I guess this is a pretty important job.
time, 9 years have gone by, friends. Summer, 1913. Gradual changes in Grover's Corners. Horses are getting rare. Farmers are coming to town now in fours. Everybody locks the house doors at night. Ain't been any burglars yet, but everybody's heard about it. This is certainly an important part of Grover's Corners. It's on a hilltop. A windy hilltop. Lots of clouds. Lots of sky. Often lots of sun and moon and stars. You come up here on a fine afternoon, you can see range on range of hills. Awful blue they are, but like Sunbeam, like Winnipesaukee. And if you go way up, you can see the White Mountains, like Mount Washington, or Conway, or North Conway is. And of course, our favorite mountain, Mount Monadnock, is right here. Surrounded by Jaffrey and North Jaffrey and Peterborough and Dublin. Way down there is Grover's Corners. Over here are the old stones. 1660, 1670. Strong-minded people come a long way to be independent. Summer people walk around and laugh at funny words on the tombstones. Don't do any harm. Genealogists come up from Boston, get paid by city people for looking up their ancestors. They want to make sure their daughters of the American Revolution and of the Mayflower. Don't do any harm either, I guess. Over here are the Civil War veterans. Iron flags in their graves, New Hampshire boys. Had a notion that the Union Army kept together, though they'd never seen more than 5 miles of themselves. All they knew was the name, friends, the United States of America. The United States of America. They wouldn't die about it. Over here's the new part of the cemetery. Here's your friend, Miss Gibbs. And Mr. Stimson, the organist of the Congregational Church. Miss Soames, who enjoyed that wedding so much, remember? And a lot of others, too. Wallace, head of the Webb's boy, whose appendix burst on a Boy Scout trip across the Notch. Yes, an awful lot of sorrow, sort of quieted down up here. People just wild and brief brought their relatives up here, and then sunny days, rainy days, snow. Y'all know how it is. A lot of thoughts come up here 9 days. There's no post office. Now, there are some things we all know, but we don't like to take them out and look at them very often. We all know that something is eternal. It ain't houses, it ain't names, it ain't earth, it ain't even the stars. We all know in our bones that something is eternal. That something's got to do with human beings. All the greatest people who ever lived have been telling us that for 5,000 years. Yet you'd be surprised how often people let go of that fact. You know, the dead don't stay interested in us living people very long. Gradually, they let go of their hold on the earth, and the ambitions they had, and the pleasures they had, and the things they suffered, and the people they loved. They get weaned away. That's the way I put it. Weaned away. Sure, they stay here a while, and the earth part of them burns up, burns away. And all that time, they're slowly getting indifferent to what's going on in Grover's Corners. They're waiting. They're waiting for something they feel is coming. Something important and great. Aren't they waiting for the eternal part of them to come out clear? Now, some things they might say might offend you, but that's the way it is. Mother and daughter, husband and wife, enemy and enemy, money and mind. All those terribly important things sort of grow pale around here. And what's left? What's left when the memory's gone and your identity is smith? Well, here are some living people. That's Joe Stoddard, our undertaker, supervising the humane grave. And that's Sam Gregg, Grover's Corners boy who went out west.
Good afternoon, Joe Stoddard.
Good afternoon. Let me see.
Do I know you? I'm Sam Craig.
Gracious sakes alive. Of all the people, I should have known you'd be back from the funeral, Sam. You've been away a while.
Yes, I've been away over 12 years. I'm in business out in Buffalo now, Joe. But I was in the East when I got news of my cousin's death. So I thought I'd combine things a little and come and see the old home.
snowing for the past several days. It stopped the night before, and they'd just begun clearing the roads. The sun was coming up.
Oh, look! There's Main Street! And Mr. Morgan's drugstore before he changed it. And the livery stables.
Yes, this is 1899. This is 14 years ago.
The town I knew was a little girl. And there's the white fence that surrounds our house. Oh, I'd forgotten that. I loved it so. Are they inside?
Yes, your mother will be coming downstairs in a few minutes to make breakfast.
Will she?
Do you remember? Your father had been away a couple of days. He came back on the early morning train.
No.
He'd been away to Western New York to make a speech at Clinton.
Come on, Bessie!
Oh, look, there's Howie Newsom and the constable. But he's dead. He died.
Morning, Bill.
Morning, Howie.
You're up early?
Yep. Got called up early to rescue a party down in Polish Town. Darn near froze to death. Got drunk and landed in the snowdrifts. Fella thought he was in bed when I struck him.
And look, there's Joe Proud.
Morning, Mr. Warren. Morning, Howie.
Morning, Joe.
Morning, Joe. Bill? Howie?
Children, children, time to get up! Mama, I'm here. How young Mama looks. I never knew Mama was ever that young. You can come and dress by the kitchen fire if you like, but hurry! Good morning, Mr. Newsom.
Morning, Mrs. Webb.
It's cold.
Yes, 10 below by my bar.
Think of it and keep yourself wrapped up.
Come on, Bessie.
Mama, I can't find my blue hair ribbon anywhere. I laid it out for you special near on the dresser. There were snake in it, bite you. Yes.
Good morning, Bill.
Good morning, Mr. Webb. You're up early.
Back visiting my college in New York State. All quiet here?
Yep. Been rescued a Polish guy. Darn near froze to death.
We must put in the paper.
Too much.
Papa.
Good morning, Mother.
How did it go, Charles?
All right, I guess. I taught him a few things. All quiet here?
Yes, can't think of anything that's happened special. It's been right cold, though. Mr. Newsom sent us 10 below zero over to his barn.
Yes, well, it was colder in Hamilton College. Students
so greatly.